before September 11th, there was the Oklahoma City bombing. April 19th, 1995, you may recall, a truck bomb ripped through this nine-story Oklahoma City federal building, which included a daycare center on the second floor. 168 men, women, and children died. Hundreds more were wounded. At the time, it was the worst terrorist attack ever on U.S. soil. The bomber, Timothy McVeigh, was executed. His co-conspirator, Terry Nichols, is serving a life sentence. And you would think everyone's happy to see Nichols rot away in prison, right? Well, not my next guest. Janie Coverdale lost two grandsons, then 5-year-old Aaron and 2-year-old Elijah in that bombing, but she forgives Terry Nichols. She joins me now on the phone from Oklahoma City. Janie, you've been corresponding with Terry Nichols the last 7 years or so. I'm curious what made you want to reach out and write that first letter.
Well, after Terry Nichols' trial in the state of Oklahoma and he didn't get the death penalty, I was very angry for a while. And then, I don't know, it was like a voice told me that there's been enough killings. You know, we needed to leave that alone. So I wanted to talk to Terry, and I have never believed that the government has told us the truth about what happened here that day. So I had a friend to get Terry's address. He was in McAllister, Oklahoma, in prison, and I wrote him a letter, and I said, now that God has seen fit to spare your life again, it's time for you to tell us what really happened. And I really didn't expect Terry to answer my letter, but he did.
You lost your two grandsons in that bombing. How long did it take you to forgive Terry Nichols?
It took me 9 years. I was angry for 9 whole years.
And what made you forgive him?
I beg your pardon?
What made you forgive him? Was it something that he said to you?
He asked me to forgive him. In one of his letters he wrote, he said, for all of the pain and heartache I've caused you and your family, please forgive me. And God said, in order for him to forgive me, I've got to forgive Terry. And that's what I started working on. It took a long time and a lot of praying, but I got rid of that anger.
And would you like to see him released one day?
Really, I don't think Terry Nichols deserved any more time than Michael Fortier got. If the government could dress Michael Fortier up, shave him, put him on the witness stand and let him lie, and he serve a minimum time, I think Terry Nichols should have too.
What do you talk about? Tell me some of the things that he has said to you that, you know, there's a lot of people who are probably wondering what he thinks about all these years locked away. So what strikes you?
And Terry and I talk about his mother because I got to know his mother during his trial in Denver. She would hold me a seat in the courtroom every morning, and she and I would sit together and we'd talk. And Terry saw me sitting with his mother, and he appreciated that. And we talk about his son that's in prison. We talk about his other two children. Terry's mother has been very ill. We talk about her. And we talk about Aaron and Elijah. I don't try to keep things from Terry. If it's close to Aaron and Elijah's birthday, I remind him. Aaron and Elijah's birthday is in September.
Is he full of guilt when you talk about the loss of your grandsons and the others?
In one letter, Terry said, my heart grieves every day for what I've done. And a lot of people don't believe him. A lot of people think Terry is just playing games. I don't.
Has he ever told you why he got involved with this horrible nightmare?
And Terry told me that was the worst decision he has ever made. And no, he hasn't told me why. I think he knows. I know why, because we've been told so much. But it's just the part where he apologized to me. And we talk about Tim. We talk about capital punishment. I don't believe in capital punishment. Terry say he does.
I don't understand that part. It sounds like you've had some very interesting correspondence with him. Janie Cover.